I'm a concept artist. I work for a Glue Mobile. I work as a concept artist and I create various environments in games, characters, whatever assets you see in games. I create them all with the help of my team, of course. Mm-hmm. And basically, I play the pre-production part of the entire production. Yeah, they should know the story, entire story, really good, really well, and the theme of the story. When is it set? What are the characters in the story? So, story is very important.
Rahul, you work with Glue. So, how has the journey been?
Yeah,
so
the journey has been great.
Any interesting anecdotes you want to share, which happen in Glue every day? Come on, it's a mobile gaming franchise, yeah. And you have everything is like so animated there, because I remember one of my friends works in Glue, so he tells me that people are just animated. They're like bubbling and bursting with energy.
Yeah.
So tell me about that.
Yeah, it's been crazy working with, like, we have to work with Hollywood companies, of course, uh-huh. Hollywood studios, of course.
Uh-huh.
And it's fun, like, creating actual actors in 3D and, like, creating an impersonation in 3D.
Okay.
Then you get into, like, you'll create that impression in 3D and the actor will say, no, I don't like this, I don't approve this, so that approval stage, it's fun.
So the approval comes from the actors themselves, actors that, okay, themselves. If they look like me.
Yeah, because the actors are the brand themselves, their face is a brand, that even that, if they have some sort of expression, like The Rock in Hercules movie,
mm-hmm.
he has this expression, right?
Where he does
so
that.
So even that is his style, no one can take that. So. It's fun trying to create that in 3D, look at it in the game.
So you make the concept art for how the character is going to look like.
Look like, yeah, yeah.
How each level progresses, how the entire look and feel also changes, because there's a certain set of skills which add on to the character.
Yeah,
so probably there'll be like extra armor, extra set of weaponry, yada, yada.
Yeah.
So how do you devise all of that? Yeah. How like what goes behind the process of creating this concept art?
So initially we start with what is grounded in reality.
Okay.
So I'll take the example of our latest game, Hercules.
Mm-hmm.
So it's based in the old Greek times, uh-huh. around 700 BC.
Uh-huh.
It tells the tale of Hercules.
Uh-huh.
So basically we take elements from that time, whatever we can gather from movies, from books and various resources online. And then we take those things and then design according to that. And we go slightly into fantasy territory. We take those things, grounded things, so that people can relate to it. And we go into fantasy, so that it's more it's more appealing to people in a way.
Okay.
So games like God of War, Blood and Glory, so those kind of games have
like all
that.
The hack and slash games.
Yeah. So they start with something grounded, they go into fantasy. So we have to say, we have to decide things like how much we want to, how far we want to go into fantasy territory, okay. and all those things. So
when you design all these aspects of the games,
mm-hmm.
you see, like you said right now, it starts at a very basic level and then it escalates tremendously,
mm-hmm.
to a certain point when it becomes too unreal, even though like you know that it's a game, but then a lot of games happen to be quite realistic when it comes to the kind of design and the kind of art.
Mm-hmm.
If I had to cite an example, Last of Us
mm-hmm.
is a very brilliant game. It's won mm-hmm. like tons of awards and it's realistic.
Mm-hmm.
That can happen.
Yeah.
So that is a very realistic type of a game design. And then mm-hmm. you have stuff like
Final Fantasy.
Yeah. So what about that? What's your take on that?
Yeah, both are appealing in their own way. In realistic games like Last of Us, you can actually feel, Last of Us is more of a story-driven game.
Yes, yes.
So it's about story and it's about gritty realism. So you can actually follow the character as he goes, you feel like you are the character. So I think it has a more personal touch. Like realistic games, they have a more personal touch.
Uh-huh.
As to what you do in your daily lives, what will you do if there is a zombie apocalypse, for example. But fantasy games, they give you some sort of a power, like you are some sort of a god.
Yeah.
So they give you some sort of fantasy that you can live up to.
So you have more leeway to play with the characters, make them do like awesome jumps and stunts and all.
So both have their own unique appeal.
Okay.
So it depends upon what you want. I like to design all kinds of games. Like I would love to jump from one fantasy game to realistic game.
So what all games have you personally concept arted for? Like what all games have you made the concept art for as of now?
Yeah, as of now, Hercules, and before that, I did some indie games, which quite obscure in a way. Like,
trust me, for a gamer, things are never obscure. They rake in the details. That's how the gamers are usually.
Yeah, there's a small iPhone game. Small iPhone games here and there. Blood Dragon, I think. It was quite a bit.
Okay, perfect. So So what's your favorite character so far, which you've designed? If I had to, ask you.
Yeah, my favorite characters would be from my personal portfolio, actually. I also create my own IP.
Uh-huh.
So I'm basically creating an IP where I create alien type creatures that have some sort of different kind of suits, alien suits, and they have to look alien. So I'm trying to find design elements for that. So I'm really kind of excited of one of the characters there. I cannot like explain it to you without images, of course, but you can
I can see that the way like you're falling short of adjectives to describe the characters. Yeah.
It's still not fleshed out. I keep on experimenting with it, but I would say I'm still yet to discover that favorite character. I'm in the process of.
Perfect. Yeah. So lastly, before I let you go, considering you're a concept artist and you've made a good number of games also for Clue. So tell me so far in your experience, which is that one game which has excelled in terms of art?
From Glue, you mean?
From Glue. And apart from Glue, if you can?
Yeah. From Glue, I would say Contract Killer is an amazing... it's for a mobile game shooter, it has really good quality. Like and gameplay is also really good.
Okay.
That's one of my favorites from Glue. And from in general, that's a lot to name. Yeah. But on the top of my
list. Every artist has that one game.
Yeah.
I saw the twinkle in your eye when you were talking about Last of Us.
Yeah. Like in fantasy, like Last of Us, of course, absolutely. I played it 3 times, like completely. And then, of course, like in fantasy, like God of War and Prince of Persia. Prince of Persia was the first game that got me crazy into concept art. I was crazy about games, and I want to program. Actually, an engineer that got into concept art. So that's one aspect, strange aspect. But when I was playing Prince of Persia, you can unlock concept art
when you finish it. Yes.
When I saw that concept art, I tried to just copy it. What is this artist thinking? How does this translate to the game? I saw all that and I just copied it and just said, that was my moment that this is what I want to do till I die.
That got you into the entire art.
That was the definitive moment. I didn't have any doubts after that. So that game
it certainly shows, Rahul. Yeah. Pleasure having you here. Yeah. Have a nice day ahead. Yeah. It was awesome meeting you.
Yeah, thank you. Here.